Welcome students of semester 4 botany honors. I hope all of you are well and safe in these particular days of pandemic COVID-19. We have already covered the topics of law of segregation and law of independent assortment in your previous college classes, and I have provided those notes in your college Google Drive link. If you have any queries regarding those notes, you can ask me through mail or WhatsApp. Today I am going to discuss about several genetic crosses, namely back cross and test cross, with subsequent cross diagram and Punnett square. Come to the topics.
So today our topics is the back cross and the trace cross. Out of it, we have to describe first the definition of back cross and the test cross, and number two, we have to see the different scenario of test cross. So come to the diagram. Here in the diagram, you clearly see that a tall, pure tall plant crosses with a pure dwarf plant. From those parent, ultimately it produces the gametes as capital T from the capital T genotype, and only small t from the small t genotype. And finally, it fuses to form the F1 progeny as capital T small t. So the F1 progeny here is capital T small t, is a tall phenotype. So from this cross, first of all, you have to clear your idea about back cross. In back cross, the F1 progeny must have to cross with any one of its parent, either with homozygous dwarf plant or homozygous tall plant. This will be called as back cross. Now, I hope it is clear to you. So now, I hope it is crystal clear to everyone that what is back cross? Back cross is any cross that involves F1 progeny with either of its parent, either with tall homozygous parent or with dwarf homozygous parent. Now you should clear about the concept of test cross. Regarding test cross, you have to clear that F1 progeny must have to cross with only homozygous recessive. That means to determine the genotype, exact genotype of the F1 progeny, you must have to cross it with its homozygous recessive parent to determine whether the F1 progeny is homozygous dominant or heterozygous dominant. It is the concept behind the test cross. Now I hope it is clear now. So come to the diagram. Here a pea plant diagram I taken from Google image.
Well, suppose a pea plant is a tall pea plant, but we don't know whether it is a pure tall, that is homozygous dominant, or it is a hybrid tall, a heterozygous dominant. So to prove that whether it is capital T or capital T small t, we have to cross it with a homozygous recessive parent. Okay, this is a very specific condition for test cross. Always the progeny have to cross with a homozygous recessive parent. So
here, suppose the case 1, unknown genotype is capital T. You see here in scenario 1, from the tall phenotypic plant only one kind of gamete produced, and from the dwarf plant only one kind of gametes are produced, and ultimately fuse those gametes to produce the tall phenotypic plant in F1 generation. So from that we can conclude that the tall plant must produce only one kind of gamete, and thus it is a homozygous dominant capital T. Now if you see the cross result in a Punnett square box, you clearly see the phenotype of the progeny here.
Here you see clearly that the Punnett square box progeny result clearly showed that all four progeny are of tall phenotype. No one is a dwarf phenotype.
Which we don't know whether it is capital T or capital T small t. But as a result of those cross result, that means within the Punnett square box, the progeny result, we can clearly see here that
within the box, only one
kind of progeny, that is tall progeny, tall plant produced only. All four are heterozygous tall here. No single dwarf plants are arise. So that indicate that the tested progeny are homozygous dominant, never the heterozygous dominant. So now it is confirmed. Suppose out of resulting progeny, only one or more than one progeny is dwarf. In that particular case, we never can tell it is a homozygous dominant. So that case, it would be the heterozygous dominant, not a homozygous dominant. Now I think it is completely clear to you. In scenario 2, I suppose to have those unknown genotype plant is a heterozygous dominant. Here, I think it is a heterozygous dominant. In that particular case, similarly, here from capital T small t genotype, there are two gametes arise. Instead of one, here two gametes arise, capital T and small t. And similarly, in like previous case, from the homozygous recessive parent, only one kind of small t arise as gametes. So ultimately, it's fused to form the F1 phenotype. But here the F1 phenotype are two different kinds. One is dwarf, one is tall. Here in scenario 2, the tall plant must producing two kinds of gametes, and therefore it is a heterozygous dominant. Now it is confirmed. Now come to the Punnett square. So if you see the scenario 2 Punnett square, here you can see within the box, out of 4 progeny, 2 are tall and 2 are dwarf. As dwarf plants also arise with the tall plant, then we can conclude that the tested progeny was confirmedly a heterozygous dominant. I think it is clear now. I hope all of you understand well. Thank you.